Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So as per the feedback and support that we got from last video, we are going to do another homework style example, this time looking at one that looks at opportunity cost, comparative advantage, and absolute advantage. Again, this is a type of question that you might see on a test, a worksheet, a handout, something of that sort. And we're gonna go over five subparts to the question you see in front of us. With that said, let's get into it. So here before us, we have this question that you very well might get on a test of your own. So the example is as follows. Jack and Kim each run a food cart that sells hot dogs and hamburgers. Jack can produce and sell 720 hot dogs or 320 hamburgers in an 8-hour shift. Kim is from another city and can only sell for a 6-hour shift. However, in that time, she can produce and sell 480 hot dogs or 250 hamburgers. So, in this example, we want to A, calculate the opportunity costs of each food item for Jack and Kim. B, we want to establish if anyone has a comparative advantage in either food and why or why not. C, we want to calculate the productivity of Jack and Kim for both goods. D, we want to establish if anyone has an absolute advantage in either good, why or why not. And then E, we're assuming that they merge their businesses, and if they do that, how should they divide up their production of hamburgers and hot dogs? So with all those questions in front of us, we're going to start with question A. So here we're being asked to calculate the opportunity costs for both food items for both people. So we're gonna have a total of four opportunity costs. We're gonna have Jack's opportunity cost for hot dogs and hamburgers, and then we're going to have Kim's opportunity cost for hot dogs and hamburgers. So let's start with this right now. It's going to be very similar to what we did last week. So we'll start with Jack's. And for Jack, to get 320 hamburgers, we'll call them ham in this case, just for short form, he has to give up 720 hot dogs. We'll call them hot for short. Which means for one hamburger, we're gonna divide both sides by 320, which means to get one hamburger, he must give up 2.25 hot dogs, which is just 720 over 320. Now, alternatively, we can say that to get 720 hot dogs, Jack must give up 320 hamburgers. Therefore, to get one hot dog, we're just going to divide both sides by 720, we're going to give up 320 over 720, which is 0.44 hamburgers. And so now we've got both Jack's opportunity costs right here and right here. And so let me record these right up in the top corner. Jack's opportunity cost for hamburgers is equal to 2.25 hot dogs. And for hot dogs, it's equal to 0.44 hamburgers. Remember that it's in terms of what you give up. So that's for Jack. Now we're going to calculate for Kim. So now we're looking at Kim. And for Kim, to get 250 hamburgers, she must give up 480 hot dogs. Therefore, we're going to divide both sides by 250 so that we have it in terms of one hamburger. And therefore, to get one hamburger, she must give up 1.92 hot dogs. So let me record this over on the side. Each hamburger comes with an opportunity cost of 1.92 of the other good, which in this case is hot dogs. Now we're going to find the very last opportunity cost, which is Kim's opportunity cost for hot dogs. And so to get 480 hot dogs, Kim must give up 250 hamburgers. And therefore, we're going to divide both sides by 480. So to get one hot dog, Kim must give up 250 over 480, which is 0.52 hamburgers. The opportunity cost of hot dogs in terms of hamburgers is to 0.52. So now we've calculated the four opportunity costs. We have Jack's opportunity cost for hamburgers, which is 2.25 hot dogs. Jack's opportunity cost for hot dogs, which is 0.44 hamburgers. Kim's opportunity cost for hamburgers, which is 1.92 hot dogs. And Kim's opportunity cost for hot dogs, which is 0.52 hamburgers. Now we're going to move on to question B. Now question B asks, does anybody have a comparative advantage? Now comparative advantage is very, very important. So the way to find comparative advantage once you have all the opportunity costs is really easy, because remember back to a different video that we made, comparative advantage is simply comparing whose opportunity cost is lower. And the person with the lower opportunity cost is said to have a comparative advantage. So let's see. Well, what do we notice here? Well, we notice that for Jack, he has a lower opportunity cost for hot dogs. It's only 0.44, which compared to 0.52, it's lower. So we say that Jack has a comparative advantage in hot dogs. And we say that because it's a lower opportunity cost. However, also remember that no one person can have a comparative advantage in both goods, which would imply that Kim must have a comparative advantage in hamburgers. Let's see if that's true. Is Kim's opportunity cost lower for hamburgers? Well, for Kim to make one hamburger, she gives up 1.92 hot dogs, whereas Jack gives up 2.25 hot dogs. So yes, in fact, Kim does have a lower opportunity cost for hamburgers, and therefore we would also add that Kim therefore has a comparative advantage in hamburgers. And the reason why is because you have a comparative advantage in the production of the good that you have a lower opportunity cost in. Let's take a look at question C. So now we're on question C and we're being asked to calculate the productivity of both Jack and Kim. Now remember, productivity is simply how much output you can produce in a given time frame. So this is pretty easy. I'm sure you guys know how to do this. So we'll start with Jack. So we'll say Jack's productivity for hot dogs, Jack's productivity for hamburgers, and then we'll take a look at Kim down here, and Kim's productivity for hot dogs, and Kim's productivity for hamburgers. Okay, so we know that Jack can make 720 hot dogs in 8 hours. 720 divided by 8 is 90 hot dogs per hour. Well, how many hamburgers can he make? Well, he can make 320 hamburgers in 8 hours, which means that in 1 hour, he can make 40 hamburgers. So 40 hamburgers per hour. Next, I've got Kim. And how many hot dogs can she make? Well, she can make 480 in 6 hours, which is equal to 80 hot dogs per hour. And last, we've got how many hamburgers she can make, and she can make 250 hamburgers in 6 hours, which is approximately 41.7 per hour. And that's that. So we've calculated the productivity for both Jack and Kim for both goods. So Jack can make 90 hot dogs per hour and 40 hamburgers per hour. Kim can make 80 hot dogs per hour and 41.7 hamburgers per hour. Now let's take a look at question D. Does anybody have an absolute advantage in either good? Why or why not? Well, as we remember from that other video we made, absolute advantage is simply who can produce more in a given amount of time. So here we can just see in an hour who can produce more of each good. For hot dogs, we look at these two numbers right here, 90 per hour or 80 per hour. Now that's obvious, 90 is greater than 80. Therefore, we would say that Jack is more productive at producing hot dogs. So we would say that Jack has an absolute advantage in producing hot dogs. Now keep in mind, unlike comparative advantage, it is possible for one person to have an absolute advantage in both goods. Let's see if that's the case. Well, comparing hamburgers, Jack can make 40 hamburgers per hour, but Kim can make 41.7 per hour. So Kim actually has the absolute advantage in hamburgers. That is, she can make more hamburgers an hour than Jack. Remember, it's possible for one person to have an absolute advantage in both goods, but it is not possible for one person to have a comparative advantage in both goods. Finally, let's take a look at question E. So for question E, we're saying, suppose Jack and Kim decide to merge their businesses. How should they divide up the production of hot dogs and hamburgers between themselves? So if they were to merge, they would want to maximize their output by producing the good that they have a comparative advantage in. This is the same as trading and specialization. So if we remember back to question A, we remember that Jack has a comparative advantage in which good? In hot dogs. And at the same time, we found out that Kim has a comparative advantage in the other good, which is hamburgers. Therefore, if they were to merge businesses, it would be best for them to specialize in producing the good that they have a comparative advantage in. Therefore, if they were to merge, Jack should make hot dogs and Kim should make hamburgers. All right, guys, so now we've gone over all five questions, A, B, C, D, and E. I advise that you review any part of it that you weren't very confident in or you're not sure about, but also to leave a comment in the comment section below if you have any questions and something doesn't make sense to you. I personally go through all the comments and I would love to answer any questions that you have about this problem. If you guys want to see more homework questions in the future, let me know. And if you have any recommendations, please again, leave them in the comment section. If you enjoyed the video, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics and homework questions you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.